We've already reviewed the cameras on the Poco X2 and they're actually pretty great, as you guys have already noticed in our camera comparison and our review video as well. But I'm pretty sure that a lot of you guys were wondering how does it compare against the Redmi Note 8 Pro, which is slightly cheaper for sure. And you guys did have comments in our camera comparison videos as well. So if you are wondering about that, you've come to the right place. In today's video, I'm going to be testing out the Poco X2's cameras against the Redmi Note 8 Pro in an in-depth Mr. Phone style camera comparison. Hi, I'm Aishar from Mr. Phone and let's get this video started. But before we move on, we'd urge you to hit that red subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it to get notified whenever Mr. Phone puts out an awesome new tech video. If you've been here before, you know the drill. On your screen are the camera specs of the two phones. Pause right now to check it in detail. I'll move on to the samples now. Let's start by analyzing the 16 megapixel pixel bin shots first. Firstly, I noticed that the file sizes are larger on the Poco X2 sample, which means the compression could be far less aggressive. At first glance, there's not much to tell except for the fact that the Poco X2 looks slightly more vibrant. Also, the Redmi Note 8 Pro shoots cooler color temperatures by default. Thankfully, this can be fixed in post easily. However, you cannot add sensor level details in post. And that is where the Poco X2 beats the Redmi Note 8 Pro. You can get slightly crisper details in the center of the image at 100% crop. Move your eyes to the Pioneer Square building on the rear. The signboards for Pepsi and the trees in the front have a clearly defined outline in the Poco X2 shot. Plus, the dynamic range is better too. Even the corners have more details with far less noise too. In the same shot taken at 64 megapixel, the Poco X2 sort of tends to create a watercolor effect in an attempt to cut down the noise, but you definitely see more details in the 64 megapixel shot. The second sample is even more telling that way, where you know you see more details. It doesn't take a genius to figure out that the Poco X2's camera is better because the names of the books on the shelf are easily legible. Overall, the Poco X2 is better, but the difference, unless you always pixel peep, is negligible. Honestly, there's no perceptible difference between the Poco X2 and the Redmi Note 8 Pro's ultra wide angle pictures. The only thing that is immediately visible is that the Poco X2 shoots up the reds in the pictures, whereas the Note 8 Pro tends to create a cooler image with boosted greens. These are minor color temperature issues that can be fixed, but lens distortion correction around the corners. Both the phones are almost on par. However, what I noticed at close crop is the Poco X2 is a tad bit crisper than the Note 8 Pro, especially when you look at the second picture. The Pioneer Square signage is easily visible on the Poco X2 sample compared to the Redmi Note 8 Pro. The more I example the close-up samples, the more I'm hard-pressed to find any differences. I mean, look at these close-up shots. I just can't tell the difference. It is almost like the same phone captured the picture too. The exposure levels are identical and so are the details. When it comes to colors, the Note 8 Pro is slightly more accurate. That's about the difference that I can tell. In the second sample, it might look like the Poco X2 has created an oversaturated image, but those are the actual colors really. The Note 8 Pro, on the other hand, has muted the color slightly to create that natural look. What I'm really glad about though is both the Poco X2 and the Note 8 Pro don't botch up the reds. I'd call this round a tie too. Let's go closer with the macro camera, shall we? Now, my only concern with the Poco X2 is the color temperature is entirely off. The actual color of the 500 rupee note is green and the Note 8 Pro has got it right. But when it comes to details, the Poco X2 is definitely way better. Just look at the crisp details at close crop. It looks stunning. Now, I took portraits of Pratik with the phone and clearly the Poco X2 looks better. It is sharp, has better facial tones, and the depth cutout is great too. But what's damn cool is the Poco X2 has even kept the wooden stool and table in focus. My only concern is that it looks a bit like a Photoshop cutout. Anyway, the X2 is better overall. In selfies, the Redmi Note 8 Pro is unequivocally better. From the details, to the noise control, to the accurate colors, these samples are damning evidence that the Poco X2 doesn't stand a chance. While selfies are the best on the Redmi Note 8 Pro, Xiaomi ends up killing selfie portraits by artificially sharpening the details. It looks damn odd on the face. However, when you look at the edge cutout, the Note 8 Pro definitely does a phenomenal job, even with the tiny strands of hair around the right side of my face. Now, the advantage that the Poco X2 has over the Redmi Note 8 Pro in 4K video recording is the availability of EIS. Therefore, the footage is stable. The Poco X2 also shoots at a higher bitrate as well, and therefore it looks more detailed. Plus, the colors are better too. So yeah, if you want to shoot 4K videos, the Poco X2 is the phone for you. However, the Redmi Note 8 Pro does have a slight advantage with the audio recording, as it is louder and clearer. But the difference is not much.
Okay guys, so now we'll be shooting a 4K 30fps video on the Poco X2 and the Redmi Note 8 Pro. So let me know if my audio is clearer from the mic input through of the Poco X2 or the Redmi Note 8 Pro. And as we pan towards the side, you will see a shift in the dynamic range hopefully. So do let me know in the comments below if the shift is better on the Poco X2 or the Redmi Note 8 Pro.
In 1080p 30fps recording, the Redmi Note 8 Pro redeems itself with a far better color palette and stabilization as well. However, you can clearly see that the phone struggles with locking focus when you pan. Again, the Poco X2 has an edge here. When you switch up the frames to shoot at 60fps, the Poco X2 again takes a better video. The wide-angle videos recorded from the phones are soft, but the Poco X2 looks slightly better for sure. I like doing the indoor test because I shoot a lot indoors, and the Poco X2 has slightly overexposed the scene here, whereas the Note 8 Pro has gone for an underexposed, contrasty look. This helps the Note 8 Pro retain more details and, you know, create better outlines as well. I like the exposure and the color reproduction of the X2 better than the Note 8 Pro, but the Note 8 Pro has more details for sure. Most people will prefer the overall look of the Poco X2 here, I believe. If I'm not wrong. When taking selfies indoors, again, the Note 8 Pro gets a really nice face tone going. I'm not a fan of the X2 selfie. In low light shots, the Poco X2 takes a clear lead over the Redmi Note 8 Pro. The sample here shows better low light sensitivity compared to the Note 8 Pro and has more details too. With night mode on, you obviously get an even sharper image with slightly heightened colors though. With flash on, the details on the Poco X2 shot just come to life. Yes, the color temperature is wrong, but that can be fixed in post. But the soft details in the Redmi Note 8 Pro samples cannot be fixed. But in low light selfies, the Redmi Note 8 Pro is undoubtedly better. These comparison selfies are proof enough in my opinion. With screen flash on, once again, the Note 8 Pro selfie looks better with the overall warm tone. But if you ask me, I would never use these pictures anywhere. So I don't even see the point in using these. I'd much rather, you know, Xiaomi and Poco give night mode option for selfies instead of low light selfie flash. But I don't know. Let me know in the comment section below if you guys use the screen flash a lot. I don't. So, you know, that's just odd for me. So we're at the end of the comparison, and the Poco X2 definitely has a better set of cameras compared to the Redmi Note 8 Pro, and which is possibly why it also costs slightly more. When you take a look at the portraits, the macros, the ultra wide angle shots, the low light shots, the videos, all of that, the Poco X2 definitely has an edge over the Note 8 Pro. But yes, the Redmi Note 8 Pro definitely takes better selfies than the Poco X2, and in certain situations like when you're shooting indoors, the Redmi Note 8 Pro tends to do a better job as well. Having said that, you know, the Poco X2 is just in its infancy right now, and there are a lot of software updates that could be coming soon, and that will improve the performance of the cameras even more. I'm expecting it to become the best camera phone under 20,000. It currently is as well, but you know, having said that, it still has some room for improvement. So what do you guys think? That was our camera comparison of the Poco X2 against the Redmi Note 8 Pro. I hope you guys liked it. Do let us know in the comment section below what you thought about it. Until next time, this is Ashar from Mr. Phone signing off. Goodbye and Godspeed, my friends.